In this video, we'll look at how to create a basic HTML JavaScript single-page application with DevExtreme. I'll define two views using the MVVM approach. I'll also add some simple actions to move between each view. I've already created a simple web page and added references to the following libraries: jQuery, Knockout, and DevExtreme. I've also referenced the DevExtreme styles for each platform so that our application maintains a native look. First, we need to create an HTML application object to turn our HTML page into an application. I'll do this within this jQuery function. It will control the application lifecycle and display view. Now, I'm going to specify a routing format and call the navigate method. To define the first view with an HTML template, add a div element with the data options attribute set to DXView. I'll name it Home. This name will be used to identify the view. Now, write Hello World within the div. All right, let's see how this works. Together with the applied CSS styles, the view's HTML template represents a view in the MVVM approach. Next, we'll create a view model for our view. We'll need to associate a JavaScript function with it. This function must have the same name as our view, Home. As you can see, I've declared it in the application's namespace. The object returned by this function will be a view model. Let's add the message field to the view model object. I'll set this field to welcome and replace the simple hello world string with the h1 element bound to the message field. And let's see what this looks like now. Great. Now let's look at how to update the UI automatically when the view model changes. I'll make the message field observable and demonstrate how the text that is bound to this field will be updated in response to the change of this field. I'll add the DX textbox widget to the view and bind the value option to an observable name field. I'll also add the DX button widget and bind its onClick function to the view model's function. In this function, I'll set the message field to the value of the name field. And let's take a look at this in the browser. Now let's look at how to navigate between views. I'll add the second view and name it Greeting. I'll add the H1 element and bind it to the message field of the Greeting view model. To navigate to the greeting view, I'll add a button to the home view and bind its onClick function to the view models function, where I'll call the navigate method and pass greeting as a parameter. To return back to the home view, I'll add a button to the greeting view and bind onClick to this registered function. And let's see how the navigation works. Now I'm going to add a toolbar to the home and greeting views and provide a transition effect when one view changes to another. To do this, I'll use one of the DevExtreme predefined layouts. And here's its markup. As you can see, there's a toolbar and a placeholder for a view in it. In addition, this markup is accompanied with required style sheets so that a page looks nice on every supported device. Here's a layout controller that uses this markup to show views. As you can see, this layout controller is activated for the simple navigation strategy. So, I'll specify this strategy for my application using the Layout Set option of the HTML application object. In order to indicate which placeholder of the applied layout is displayed, I'll wrap the view's markup by the div element with the data options attribute set to DX content. And let's take a look at this in the browser. Now a transition from one view to another is animated, a toolbar is available, and a back button is added to it automatically. Let's remove our implementation of the back button and specify the title markup option for our views so that their names are displayed on the toolbar. We can also pass the text entered in the home view to the greeting view and concatenate it to the hello string. Add the name parameter to the application's routing format and set the parameter's default value to an empty string. Now let's expand the parameter list passed in the navigate function with a value of the name field. This will conform to the new routing format. I made the message field of the greeting view model observable and set this field to the text passed as a parameter from the view's URL. And let's take a look. As you can see, we've built this simple but rather functional application easily using the DevExtreme framework. And that's it for this video. To learn more about DevExtreme, make sure to check out the documentation on our website. Thanks for watching, and thank you for choosing DevExpress.